Esselamu aleyküm ve rahmetullahi ve berekatühü. Sevgili kardeşlerim, can dostlarım,
dear friends, friends of my heart and friends of my life.
Bir defa daha Allah'ın huzurunda, Allah'ın bir zikir sohbetinde birlikteyiz.
Thank and praise Allah countless times that we are in the presence of Allah today to talk about Allah once more. And we love all of you so very much. And we know that love is a big grace from Allah. And hate is a dreadful trap of Satan. To make people enemies to each other. Instead of loving each other, Satan's purpose is to make everyone hate each other. And what Allah wants is for everyone to be united in the way of Allah and love each other as well as love Allah.
Zaman her an, saniye saniye, dakika dakika ilerliyor.
Dear friends, time is going on, second by second, minute by minute. And our life goes on to an end.
Netice itibariyle hepimiz birer insanız.
And after all, we are all human beings. We were born one day, and one day death is going to knock on our doors.
Ne demişler? Baki kalan bu kubbede bir hoş sadaymış.
So the proverb says, what we leave behind is a good memory from us.
Çok eser kalacak geriye. Konuşmalarımız, sizlerle geçirdiğimiz bu güzel günlerin birer hatırası.
And of course we will be leaving lots of memories behind us. We are leaving all these speeches. We will have the memories of the days that we passed together with you. And we have always lived the peace of loving you, having you around us. And on a world built upon love, those who love others will always be happy. And the ones who hate others have selected to be unhappy with their own hand. So when you talk about friends of Allah, those are the ones who love. And Satan's friends are the ones who hate.
Böyle olmaması lazım. Hepimiz Allah'ın bize tayin ettiği ömür neyse o kadar yaşayacağız.
When there is the option to love, we should never hate. Because we will all live in the time period that Allah has granted us as life, and then we will leave this world. And Allah has blessed us, our lives, in this planet Earth. And we will live as long as He wants us to live. But that is a destiny. And for everyone, that's what's going to happen.
Öyleyse etrafımızdaki insanları sevmeliyiz.
That's why we should always love the people around us. We should love them so that they would love us.
Sevgiyle dolu, dop dolu bir hayatın sahibi olmalıyız.
We should have a life that is full of love. Those who love are loved, and those who hate will always be hated.
Bu genel kaydedir ama Allah'ın dostları kendilerinden nefret edenlerden de nefret etmezler, edemezler.
Nefret yes, that's the general rule. But Allah's friends cannot hate those who hate them, because they do not have the vice of hate in their soul's heart anymore.
Severler.
They only love, and they sometimes pity them. They pity the ones who treat others badly, who do bad things to us or make other people uncomfortable. They pity them because they love them too. And the fact that they will be going to hell is going to be a big problem for those who love those people. Because Allah's friends want everyone in the face of earth to save themselves from hell, and on the world make them happy by teaching them to make others happy. So at the end they can end up in heaven instead of hell.
Belli bir süre geçirecek olan hayatı yaşasınlar. O hayat olsun. İster ölümden sonraki hayat olsun. İkisi birbirine.
So it is either this world or the world after our life. These two are related to each other. Because in this world or in this life, the people who want to fulfill Allah's orders are the ones who will be going to heavens. And they try to make others happy with all that they have, because they know that they will feel the same happiness as the one that they give to others. So such a behavior is something that is of utmost value to them, because they love everyone, and they love everyone in the name of Allah, and they become friends in the name of Allah. And they live for Allah.
Bu yaşantı boyunca başkalarına bakış açıları onlara zarar verici bir hüviyet taşıyamaz.
And during this life, their attitude towards other people can never be in a way that would hurt others. Even when the other people are enemies to them, this person can never become an enemy to other people, because he learned how to love from Allah. And the one that teaches you how to hate, which is Satan, could never reach his heart and put hate in his heart. Satan can never achieve this. So those people have some people who they love, and there are also some that they love so much, but there are no people that they can ever hate.
Öyleyse dünyada verilen bu gezegendeki hayat, her insanın Allah-u Teala tarafından ezelde takdir edilen bir süreci yaşamasını mutlaka bünyesine alır.
So the life on the face of earth is a time period which Allah has granted to us before we come to this earth. And this life can be lived in a way that could earn you degrees all the time. Those people can never hate others, they can never hurt others, and they can never do things that would be bad to other people.
Allah'a teslim etmiş olanların davranış biçimlerini tamamen, özellikle fonksiyonları itibariyle.
So those who submit their spirits, their physical bodies, their souls and their free wills will be controlled by Allah, and this kind of control will never lead them to do something wrong that would lead them to lose degrees. But these people always love others. Even when somebody hates them, they would still love that person. They can never hate them, because they do not have those conditions in their hearts to hate others. Because when they reached continuous zikr, there are no more vices, there is no more vice of hate in this person's heart. And they only love. And they also pity others who try to make people enemies to them, because Allah's friends know how these guys will be punished in hell.
Onun için kendilerine düşmanlık edenleri de severler.
That's why they always love everyone, even when they are enemies to that person. And they would pity them simply because they would be losing because of their behaviors.
Sevmek Allah-u Teala'nın temel kanunudur.
So for everyone, Allah's primary order is to love others.
Çalışmasından başka bir şey yoktur diyor Allah Teala.
Allah says there is nothing else but working for the human being. So what kind of a work should this be?
O kişiyi cennete ulaştıracak olan bir çalışma olması.
This work should be a type of work which should lead this person to heavens in the afterlife. And every second of our lives we earn degrees. Degrees are written to our account.
Her an derecat kazanmak Allah'ın zikrini devamlı yapan insanlar için.
So earning degrees every second is possible when you reach continuous zikr. Anybody who has reached continuous zikr will earn degrees every second simply because they are doing continuous zikr. As they reached continuous zikr, their hearts do not have vices anymore. They can never do something bad to other people.
Allah'a kendilerine düşmanlık edenler için hep yalvarırlar. Onlara öğret Allah'ım. Başka insanlara güzel davranmaları.
They always pray to Allah to teach everybody about how to be happy, about how to go to heavens, about how to learn about these good behaviors and save themselves from hell. And they also would be loved by everybody else because they would be loving everyone around them.
Sevgili kardeşlerim, Allah Teala istiyor ki herkes mutlu olsun. Allah Teala istiyor ki
Allah wants everyone to be happy. Allah wants everyone to love each other. But Allah also gave everyone free wills so that people can decide with their own free wills whether to go to heavens or hell. And this is a very reasonable design for everyone because what you sow shall you reap in the afterlife.
Hayatını başkalarına kötülük etmekle geçiren bir insan için bu dünyada huzur ve mutluluk yaşanması mümkün değildir. Şeytan onları kıskacına almıştır. Onlara başkalarına kötülük ettirmektedir. Ve başkalarından da onlar devamlı kötülük görmektedirler.
For someone who always treats others badly can never get out of unhappiness in their lives. Satan can get them to do whatever he wants them to do. And such a life can never bring happiness to someone. But for someone who has gone into Allah's way by making the wish to reach their spirits to Allah, they immediately will start to feel that desire to reach their murshids and go and take repentance from them. So anyone who has made the wish to reach their spirits to Allah will make this person owners of first heavens in the afterlife.
Allah'ın kendilerine
so anyone who has really made the wish from their hearts to reach their spirits to Allah, Allah will immediately give them to the desire to reach their murshids, and this love is going to take them to repentance in front of their murshids, in front of their religious guides. If that person died at that moment, he would be the owner of the second heavens. But if he lives on, then Allah gives the guarantee to reach his spirit to himself. And that would mean that he would be the owner of the third heavens in the afterlife. And this is a complete guarantee for everyone. So whoever wants to reach me, Allah says, I will make him reach myself. And this is Allah's guarantee. This is Allah's promise. And he has put it in Quran.
Allah Teala sözünü yerine getirememezlik eder mi?
And it is not possible for Allah not to fulfill his promise. It is impossible to think that. And Allah is the Almighty, he is the omnipotent, and he can do everything, and he will definitely fulfill his promise.
Kanunlarını koymuştur. Ama bütün insanlara serbest irade vermiştir. Herkes.
So he loves the human beings the most, and he also put his laws. And he also gave the free will to human beings. So everybody is going to earn heavens or hell based on their own decisions, based on their own actions. And everybody's life is recorded every moment by the Kiram and Katibin angels. And every moment we either lose or earn degrees. And all these degrees are written in the movie that is being recorded. So if we had the opportunity to look at our lives movies, we would be able to see at that moment as a cumulative number how many degrees we earned and how many degrees we lost.
Allah Teala'nın bu konuya vakfettiği kiramen katibin melekleri.
So the angels that Allah commissioned for this duty always work in pairs. One of them is a witness and the other one is the scribe. And every second of our life is being recorded in a three-dimensional recording, in a three-dimensional video. So every moment we either lose or earn degrees. It is not possible to spend 1 second without either losing or earning degrees. And Allah wants everyone in this lifetime to be happy and also make others happy. And then go into heavens as a result. And they will stay there forever.
Bütün insanlar için sadece iki tane alternatif var. Ya Allah'ın cennetine girmek veya cehenneme girmek.
So dear brothers and sisters, we only have two alternatives. It is either going into heavens or going into hell.
O zaman yedi cennetin kapılarına baktığımız zaman,
and then we look at the gates of the seven heavens, we see that for someone who makes the wish to reach their spirits to Allah and dies will be going into the first heavens. And when the person takes repentance from his religious guide and then die afterwards would mean that he would be going into second heavens. For someone who has actually reached their spirits to Allah, who has achieved that submission of spirits, will be going into third heavens. And anyone who can submit, surrender his physical body to Allah is going to be going into fourth heavens. And anyone who has completely purified and submitted his soul to Allah will be going into fifth heavens. And for someone who Allah embellished their hearts will be going into sixth heavens. And then anyone who has submitted his free will to Allah will be going into seventh heavens. So, dear friends, our life in this world will be very short. And those will be very happy who will be able to go into heavens in the afterlife. That will be a huge joy for those people. And anyone who has more degrees, more positive degrees than their negative degrees, will be going into heaven. That is Allah's law.
Göz atalım. Bir insan ki hayatını kendisine en güzel mutlulukları yaşayacak şekilde çevirerek yaşıyor.
Let's take a look at our worldly life. Think about a person who has made it his purpose to do everything to live a happy life. So he made the wish to reach his spirit to Allah. And he couldn't go any further than that. So this person, as soon as he makes the wish to reach his spirit to Allah and then dies the next second, he will be going into the first heavens. If he lives and takes repentance from his religious guide, he would be going into second heavens. And anyone who reaches his murshid, who reaches his religious guide and takes repentance, for these people Allah has promised to reach their spirits to himself. Allah says very clearly, whoever wants to reach me, I will make them reach myself. So these people that Allah mentions are the ones who take repentance, and Allah guarantees this, and Allah always fulfills this submission for the person.
Allah'a ruhunu ulaştırdıktan sonra o kişiye ölüm gelse,
so if the person dies after he submits his spirit to Allah, or after he delivers his spirit to Allah, he will be going into third heavens. This is so nice because he did not do anything. He only made the sincere wish from the heart to reach his spirit to Allah. And upon his wish, Allah has first given him the love for his religious guide and gave him the opportunity to reach and take repentance from his religious guide. And when his spirit leaves his body, when he takes repentance, Allah also delivers the person's spirit to himself, because it is his promise. And this promise is very clear. Allah says, whoever wants to reach me, I will help him reach myself. I will make him reach myself. And Allah always fulfills his promise. And that person is going to deliver his spirit, or Allah is going to deliver this person's spirit to himself under normal conditions in about 7 to 8 months. So either we say that Allah makes this person reach his spirit to Allah, or the person can put his effort to reach his spirit to Allah, and it is Allah who gave him this effort anyway. But this person is going to be the owner of third heavens when he dies. And Allah's judgment about this is very clear. Again, Allah says, whoever wants to reach his spirit to me, I will make him reach myself.
O kişinin Allah'a ulaşmayı diledikten sonra 7-8 aylık bir ömrü varsa, mürşidine tabi olduktan sonra 7-8 aylık bir ömrü varsa,
so if the person has about 7 to 8 months of life after he takes repentance from his religious guide, Allah is definitely going to reach this person's spirit to himself. So dear friends, people can be either happy on or unhappy in this world. But please know this, that what makes you unhappy are the vices in your soul's heart. Your vices are very selfish. They always want you to hurt others. They always want you to make others uncomfortable.
Başkalarını mutlu etmenizi ve onlara verdiğiniz mutluluğun,
but the virtues in our spirit will always want us to make others happy, so that we would live the same happiness evet. as we give to other people.
Söz konusu olan şey ruhunuzun hasletlerine tabi olmanız.
So the important thing is to follow our mesela spirit's sevmek, demands, to follow our virtues. Nefret, for example, loving nefret, is a virtue nefret. From our spirit, but hate is a vice in our soul's heart.
Sevgili kardeşlerim, bu afetleri önleyecek olan şey Allah'ın ismini Allah,
dear friends,
Allah, Allah,
what is going
Allah,
to prevent yeah. these vices from being Allah, strong is yeah. repeating Allah's name like Allah, Allah, yeah. Allah, Allah, Allah, Allah, or silently with your inner voice, or maybe even not moving your tongue, but just doing with your heart's sound or with your inner sound to repeat Allah's name. This is the only thing which can remove your soul's vices. And Kiram and Katibin angels will see all these. And those angels around you will be praying for you to do the good things. And they are always following you every moment. And they are recording all your actions into the movie of your lives.
Görüntü,
as we would call it, the book of our lives. But this book has both video
kayıtlar söz konusudur.
And also the recordings.
Üç boyutlu görüntünüz.
This video is in our lives, three-dimensional recording. And throughout our lives, those recordings will be kept. But also, the degrees that we earn or the degrees that we lose are also being recorded all the time. The positive degrees in the green numbers and negative degrees in the red numbers. So when our life ends or when we die, which side is greater is very important, because if the degrees that we earned are higher, which means the positive degrees are more than the negative degrees, then we would be going into heavens. Even if they are greater by one degree, we would be going into heavens. And if the person's negative degrees are more than their positive degrees, unfortunately this person is going to be going to hell.
Hiç kimseyi suçlamaya hakkı yoktur. Neden öyle söylüyoruz?
Unfortunately, the person has prepared this with his own decisions. Because, for example, if somebody does something bad to you, such a behavior, such a bad behavior from somebody else would only make them earn degrees. So this person would earn degrees if somebody else did something bad to them. So such behaviors, such bad behaviors from other people are actually helping us towards going into heavens. And my dear friends, both life in heaven and life in hell are endless. It is infinite. And our life in this world is 100 years, maybe at most 150 years. But when you compare 150 years with infinity, it is nothing. But this worldly life is very important, because the degrees that we earn in this life, whether we earn more positive degrees or more negative degrees, is going to determine whether we will be going to heavens or hell. And this calculation that Allah makes is very easy. Every moment, those Kiram and Katibin angels continuously calculate the degrees that we earn, and they cumulatively record those numbers every moment.
Takip edici hem de yazıcı melekleri.
And as we said, every person has a witness and a scribe, a pair of angels that are commissioned for this purpose.
Bütün insanlar için mutluluk Allah Teala'nın istediği şeydir.
Dear friends, for everyone, happiness is what Allah wants for their lifetime. And Allah has prepared all His orders for that purpose.
Allah'ın standartlarında ruh Allah'ın ruhudur.
And the spirit in us is Allah's spirit. And that spirit wants always the most beautiful, the happiest for the human beings. And they always want everyone to earn degrees all the time. But as I said, Allah gives human beings the free will so that they would be able to make their own selections. They would be able to make their own decisions and select whether they would be going into heaven or hell. And there is no injustice in this, because Allah gave them total freedom to do whatever they want in their lifetime. And at the end of your life, according to your behaviors in your lifetime, if you have more positive degrees than your negative degrees, then you will be going into heavens. But if you have more negative degrees than positive degrees at the end of your life, then the person is going to go to hell. So a person needs to always adapt his life to earn positive degrees.
Bunun mutluluğunu mutlaka yaşarsınız sevgili kardeşlerim. Ama kime kötü davranırsanız, o kötü davranışınızla o kişiyi üzerseniz, ona zarar verirseniz, o zaman da
so if we treat someone in a good way, then we would be earning degrees and we would also be happy.
Sizin kendi iradenizdir.
Or if we treat them badly, then we would be losing degrees. So in both cases, it is our free will who makes the decision. And Allah does not interfere with free wills. Why? Because Allah is the owner of justice and He always acts with justice. And for a human being, it is important so that they would use their minds and use their free wills to fulfill Allah's orders and make other people happy.
İşte bu hedeftir.
And this is one of the objectives of our lives.
Bir başkasını mutlu etmek istikametine bir gayretin sahibi ise, o gayret başarılsın ya da başarılamasın.
So whoever wants to make somebody happy, whether he actually becomes successful in making him happy or not,
rahatsız etmek istikametine,
but he would still earn those positive degrees.
Derecat kaybetmez. Bu kayıp ancak o kişinin başka birine bu düşüncesiyle zarar verdiği noktada.
So even when we think to make other people happy, and even if we are not successful, but we have good intentions, we would still earn degrees. But on the flip side, if we think of making someone unhappy or do something bad, if we think of doing something bad, we would not lose degrees until the moment that we actually put it in action.
İstiyor ki bu mutluluğumuz çoğunlukla başkalarımızı.
So Allah always wants us to be happy, and our happiness is mostly related or dependent on us making others happy. And Allah prefers us to make others happy and become happy that way.
Allah Teala ayaktayken zikredin diyor, otururken zikredin.
And Allah orders us to do zikir while we are standing, or while we are sitting, or when we are sleeping on our sides. So firstly, Allah orders us to sleep on our sides, and so that we can do zikr of Allah while we are sleeping. So in both three states, we should always keep repeating Allah's name. And to be able to do this, we have to be able to fall asleep while doing Allah's zikr, while repeating Allah's name. So if we sleep while repeating Allah's name, when we wake up, we will see that we are still repeating Allah's name, and that will be a huge joy for us, because we will be thanking and praising Allah, and we will be saying that we have continued to do zikir all throughout the night as we were sleeping.
Sonucu nedir? Nefsinin kalbinde daim zikri ulaşanlar için artık afet kalmaz.
And for someone who has continuous zikir, do not have any more vices in their soul's heart. And these people are the happiest people on the face of earth. It is not possible for them to hate others or look at them with envy or with hate or try to take revenge from them. It is not possible because they are owners of continuous zikir.
Bütün insanlar bunlar için düşmanlık edilmesi mümkün olmayan bir hüviyet taşır.
So for them, no human being can be an enemy. Even when somebody can see them as their enemies, Allah's friends will never do something like that. And even when Allah gives everyone to write the right to take revenge, Allah's friends never want to take revenge because such a demand that never comes from their soul's hearts because they are owners of continuous zikr.
Allah Teala'nın istediği nedir diye olaylar dizisine baktığımızda net ve açık olarak görürüz ki Allah Teala bizden mutlu olmamızı istiyor.
So if we look at what Allah wants from us, we see very clearly that Allah wants us to be happy. And the easiest way to be happy is to live for other people. Because every moment we can do something nice to someone. We can always try to find a way to do something nice for somebody else. If this is your purpose in life, if your behaviors and if your mind is always filled with this idea, then you are one of Allah's closest friends. And this is an uninterruptible happiness.
Allah'ın dostu olup çok zikrederek, daimi zikre ulaşarak Allah'ın dostu olmak.
And to become a friend to Allah by doing a lot of zikir and reaching continuous zikir and eventually reaching continuous zikir and reaching highest levels of happinesses. When there is this option, why would you try to make others unhappy and also make your life miserable? Because anyone who hurts others or anyone who does something bad to other people will always feel that in their conscience. And Allah will always give them that torment in their souls. And such a person, if he achieves his purpose, is just going to make them someone who hurts others just for his own soul. So every time a person does something bad, he is going to feel that stress, he is going to feel that unhappiness inside him. Because Allah definitely gives them this torment so that they would not do the same thing again and not hurt others again. But despite all these, there are some people who have darknesses in their hearts and they will continue treating others badly. So as long as the earth exists, those people will continue to exist. So we should forgive them and we should always try to treat everyone in the best way possible and also set the best examples for everyone. And also love others, love each other and be loved by everyone.
Allah Teala hepinizi çok ama çok seviyor. Bu sevgi halin
halesi. So dear friends, Allah loves all of you so very much And Allah wants all of you to be very happy. And we are praying for all of you to be happy, and Allah reaches you to the highest levels of happinesses.
Fatiha ve as-salavat. Esselamu aleyküm ve rahmetullahi ve berekatühü.